Hello, my dear boys and girls. Welcome to your biology class. So, last class we learned about the development of embryo in hen, isn't it? So, and we also learned about formation of young ones to the adults. In today's class, what we are going to learn is about the developmental stages of the frog. This development shown by the frogs. So, now what makes frog different from other organisms? What difference does development of frog has from other organisms? Yes, as most other organisms, the young ones are looking similar to the adults, isn't it? But certain organisms, some organisms like insects, frogs, etc., they are having young ones with stages of growth, isn't it? Today we are going to learn the development of frog. So for that we are going to learn from the young stage onwards. Now what is the mode of fertilization frog has? What mode of fertilization does the frog has, dear children? Yes, the frog is having which mode of fertilization? External fertilization, isn't it? When we learned about external fertilization, we learned that frogs, aquatic animals, etc. are having external fertilization. That is, the male frog will lay lot of eggs in the water, and after that the female frog also will move to the pond and lay the eggs. Thus externally the fusion of the gametes happens, and thus the zygote is formed. The zygote develops, isn't it? So that is how the external fertilization occurs. Now in frog, after the development of the embryo, the eggs get hatched into tadpole. So you may have seen the tadpole. What is the specialty of the tadpole? Yes, they are free swimming in nature. They look similar to the young fishes. They will be freely swimming in the water, isn't it? They are aquatic in nature. They have tail. They have a head and tail. They are aquatic in nature and they swim like the fishes, isn't it? During rainy season in ponds or streams, you may have seen the tadpole. So these tadpoles are small fish-like larvae of the frog. Now, they are free swimming in nature. After a few days, what happens is they will develop the limbs. They will develop the frog. Limbs will be formed on the tadpole. So, likewise, they will lose the tail and they will become the young frogs. And these young frogs are able to move to the land. So, here the egg hatches into the tadpole and the tadpole grows, the limb develops on the tadpole and they grows into young frogs, and this young frogs are able to crawl onto the land. And likewise the frog grows, and likewise an adult frog grows from a young frog. So this is how the development of frog occurs. So teacher will demonstrate the development on board. That is, first egg will be formed. And after that, egg hatches into pole. So now here, this flowchart shows how the frog is developed from the eggs. That is, first the eggs will be formed. How is the eggs formed? Dear children? Yes, egg is formed by external fertilization, isn't it? External fertilization. By external fertilization, egg is formed and egg hatches into, isn't it? Hatches into tadpole. And what is the nature of the tadpole, dear children? Yes, tadpole are fish-like larvae. They are free swimming in nature, and after a few days what happens? The limbs develop, isn't it? So the limbs develops and this tadpole become the young frogs, isn't it? So limbs develop. Now, and after that, the young frog develop into the adult frog, isn't it? So that is how the development of the frog happens. So the transformation of larvae into adult through various stages of life is called metamorphosis. What is it called? What it is called, dear children? Metamorphosis. Metamorphosis. So can you give me few other examples of organisms which shows this metamorphosis, dear children? Yes, you may have seen the mosquitoes hatching. So mosquitoes are also example. Then moths are example. Yes, very good. Butterflies are example. So these are the examples for the organisms which shows the metamorphosis. So here we learn, today's class we learned about the metamorphosis shown by the frog, that is the egg hatches into the tadpole. Tadpole develops wing and form young frog, and later it develop into adult frog. So till the tadpole stage, till this tadpole stage, the young frog will be continuing in the water. After that, the frog will move to the land. In your textbook, page number 102, there is a diagram given, that is figure 9.11, which shows the life cycle of frog. So kindly go through that picture and also go through the textbook. See you in next class. Thank you.
Ones to adults. The new individuals which are born or hatched from the eggs continue to grow till they become adults. Mostly, the young ones have similar shape and structure as their parents. But in some cases, the young ones look different from the adults. Animals like frogs, mosquitoes and butterflies have different stages of development between hatching of eggs and the formation of an adult individual. Development of frog or metamorphosis. An adult female frog lays a large number of eggs in water. After some time, the eggs hatch into small, fish-like larvae called tadpoles that grow larger as they feed on algae and bits of plant material. The tadpole grows its limbs. After the development of both pairs of limbs, the young frog crawls on the land. The tail is resorbed, removed by gradual breakdown, and the frog continues to grow until it reaches its adult body size. The transformation of the larva into the adult through drastic changes is called metamorphosis. In case of mosquitoes, when the egg hatches, a worm-like larva comes out. In about 2 weeks, it changes into an adult mosquito. Butterflies and moths also pass through the larva and pupa stages before the winged adult is born.